Hello and welcome to a new series of SnowRunner on Hard Mode. For anyone not familiar with Hard Mode, I'll put the key rule changes up on the screen. In addition, I'll be adding the following conditions to this playthrough. No mods, no co-op multiplayer, main regional progress tasks must be completed to unlock the next region, and regions must be unlocked in order. So to unlock the Alaska region, we'll need ticks against all the regional progress tasks in Michigan, and to unlock Tamir, we'll need all ticks against regional progress in Alaska, and so on. No DLC vehicles prior to arriving in Kola Peninsula. The first priority is to discover the Fleet Star and get it up and running. We could tow it to the garage and pay $2,500 to have it repaired, but there's a service trailer already sitting at the garage which we can use instead. To fully repair the Fleet Star, we need to use 530 repair points and 6 tyres from the service trailer. It also has no fuel in it, so we need to take some from the Chevy. The Fleet Star will be our primary vehicle for delivery missions in the early stages of the game, but it also provides a way to rescue our scout vehicles if they get stuck. There are a few upgrades, watchtowers, and other vehicles we can discover with the pickup as it is, so that's next on the list. The raised suspension upgrade for the GMC 9500 isn't far from the garage. There's a fuel trailer near the farm which we can use to fill up our vehicles for free. Hard mode's all about resource and risk management, so we'll definitely need to make the best use of the available free fuel that we can. Sticking to the paths along the western side of the map will lead us to the raised suspension upgrade for the Chevy pickup, and an engine upgrade which can be sold. The 5.2 is actually the most powerful engine upgrade available for the Chevy, but it burns a lot of fuel and reduces the vehicle's range to a point that, in my personal opinion, it's just not worth using in hard mode. Continuing along the west side of the map, we can take a bit of a shortcut and discover the International Scout 800. I'll leave the CK1500 and run the Scout down the hill. While it is somewhat more capable in mud due to its lock differentials, the Scout has a narrower track and a higher centre mass than the CK1500, so it's much more likely to tip over. This makes it somewhat of a liability to use as a primary Scout vehicle in hard mode. I'll skip back to the CK1500 and we can head back towards the town, picking up some jobs along the way. The last upgrade on the list for this trip is the raised suspension upgrade for the Fleet Star, which is just over the river past the lumber mill. We can pick up the wooden bridge job, then head back past the lumber mill to discover the GMC 9500. With most of the western side of the map explored, we can jump into the GMC and take it back to the garage. The sideboard bed can be removed so it can be used on the Fleet Star. I'll replace it with a low saddle instead. Back into the garage, we can install the raised suspension upgrade on the Fleet Star and sell the original suspension. We can also install 45-inch tyres. I'm going to add a snorkel and I'm going to install the all-wheel drive upgrade. I'll add the sideboard bed we removed from the GMC, and I'm going to buy a loading crane, so we won't have to pay to auto-load cargo. We can take some more fuel from the GMC and pick up the Curtainside trailer, which can be dropped off at the farm to complete the farming tools mission. Pick up the fuel carrier at the trailer park, and rather than taking it back to the garage, at this stage I think it's better to drop it off in the town to make refueling during some of the early delivery missions more convenient. Switching back to the GMC, we can drop off the service trailer in town as well, but hopefully we won't need to use it too regularly. The GMC does struggle in some sections and may require winching if it starts to dig in. After dropping off the service trailer and refueling, the GMC can hook up to the flatbed semi-trailer near the town, which has some cargo we'll need for later missions. Switching back to the Fleet Star, the main priority now is to open up as many of the main roads as we can. First on the list is the Rock Slide mission. We can grab some metal beams from the town storage. The loading crane is needed here, as auto-loading cargo will cost $150 per item. To complete the Rock Slide mission, we'll also need some service spare parts, which are conveniently already on a trailer just around the corner. With the Rock Slide mission complete, we've reached rank 3. I think we'll leave it there for this episode. Thanks for watching.